Welcome to Cell Clips. In this video, we will be talking about membranes. These structures are important for cell organization because they create barriers around the cell and each of its organelles, including the mitochondria, the nucleus, the ER, and the Golgi apparatus. This separation allows specialized environments to be maintained within various parts of the cell to ensure that cell processes occur in the proper location and order. For example, lysosomes maintain a very acidic pH to degrade cell waste products, and the cell's DNA is confined to the nucleus. To better understand how and why membranes form, let's take a closer look at their structure. Membranes are made of two layers of phospholipids. Phospholipids have a glycerol backbone composed of three carbons with functional groups attached. Two of the carbons are linked to long chains of hydrocarbons, making one side of the molecule hydrophobic. The fatty acid chains can have different lengths and degrees of saturation, which allows for variation in the rigidity of the membrane. The third carbon has a phosphate group attached, making it charged and hydrophilic. The phosphate head can be modified with different functional groups. Most commonly, they have a choline group attached, but several others also exist, including phosphatidic acid, which simply has a hydrogen attached, or phosphatidyl inositol, which can be phosphorylated in different ways to control cellular processes. The specific lipid makeup of a membrane will control its behavior and chemical properties. Thus, the lipid composition of cellular membranes differs between leaflets of a single membrane, between organelles of the same cell, and between similar organelles in different cell types to meet their distinct needs. The chemical properties of phospholipids can explain their organization in a membrane. Cells reside in aqueous environments, and since hydrophobic regions repel water, the lowest energy conformation for phospholipids is for two layers of hydrophobic tails to orient toward each other, with polar heads protecting them on both sides. The hydrophobic tails can further be protected from water when these bilayers form a sphere. This layer structure with tightly packed molecules containing both hydrophilic and hydrophobic regions creates a protected space that cannot easily be permeated by ions or large molecules, making them excellent barriers for the cell and its organelles. But providing barriers in the cell is not the only function of membranes. Membranes also provide a place for proteins, such as transporters, receptors, and cell adhesion proteins, to bind and function. We will see these proteins in action throughout the series, but today we will focus on their categorization and structure. Membrane proteins can be categorized into two main types, integral and peripheral. Integral membrane proteins are permanently attached to the membrane and usually span across both the hydrophilic and hydrophobic layers. The transmembrane domains of these proteins are composed of either alpha helices or beta sheets, with specific hydrophilic and hydrophobic regions to match the corresponding regions in the lipids. Transmembrane beta sheets commonly coil together to form beta barrel pore proteins, which form channels to allow molecules to be transported across the membrane. Transmembrane alpha helices have 20 to 25 hydrophobic amino acids that reside inside the membrane and two hydrophilic ends extending out on either side. These transmembrane domains keep integral membrane proteins permanently bound to the membrane. Peripheral membrane proteins, on the other hand, are only temporarily attached to membranes. Some of these proteins bind to integral membrane proteins, while others bind to outer regions of the membrane without crossing it entirely. This allows peripheral proteins to assemble just long enough for a specific process to occur and then disassemble until they are needed again. So to summarize, membranes are critical to the organization of the cell. They create barriers between the cell and its external environment, as well as barriers around each organelle. This allows the cell to maintain high concentrations of certain proteins and ions within the organelles, and allows cell processes to be carried out in an orderly and efficient way. Membranes consist of phospholipids with hydrophilic heads and hydrophobic tails. The exact nature of the head and tail groups can control various properties of the membrane. Membranes are permanently bound by integral membrane proteins containing transmembrane alpha helices or beta barrels, and temporarily bound by peripheral membrane proteins that attach on one side of the membrane or to integral proteins. Integral and peripheral proteins are important in forming channels, receptors, and adhesions that mediate numerous cellular processes. Hopefully from this video, you can see that membranes are not just passive boundaries, but provide the protection, structure, and organization fundamental to nearly every cell process. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching Cell Clips.